Somerset House is the headquarters of Dot Everyone, the organisation set up by Martha Lane Fox to build Britain's brilliant digital future. I'm lucky to catch Martha to ask her her views about digital capabilities in education. Martha is a very busy person. Amongst other things, she's on the board of Twitter, Chancellor of the Open University, a member of the House of Lords, and still finds time to run Dot Everyone. What are, in her view, the priorities for a digital future for Britain?
I think that the UK has a huge opportunity to become a world leader. We've got some fantastic digital fundamentals, but there are some things that are still quite broken. And I would argue one of those is around skills, both basic digital skills and more advanced skills. We know that there are 12 million adults in the UK who cannot do 6 basic things online. And they're really important when you're looking for work, when you're trying to save money, when you're applying for jobs and so on. And we also know that we need a huge number of much more advanced and deep technical skills. Right now, there are 600,000 empty jobs that we could fill if we had a bit more robust training. So some things are going very well, some things are going less well, but I think we have a huge opportunity to make a big leap forward.
You use your organisation as a base for your campaign for Digital Britain. How can universities and colleges help?
Dot Everyone is a new kind of organisation. We want to make the UK an absolute world leader in digital, and we are focused on not only fixing what's broken, but showing what's possible. Universities are obviously a big and important part of the mix because of the reach that they have and the important role that they play in society. So we'd love universities to become partners, part of our Dot Everyone campus. Anyone is welcome to join, but bear with us because we're just starting. We're a startup, and you'll see much more coming out of us over this year.
What messages do you have for senior managers in universities and colleges?
My father is an academic. He's not management, but he is certainly a senior member of a university. And my observation from watching both him, my role through the OU, and knowing the sector a little bit, is that there is still a bit of a gap in terms of digital skills. You know, some people who whizzing around, practically able to code, and other academics who, why would they? It's maybe out of their experience. But I would just urge everyone working in the sector to see it as part of their responsibility in their job to get learning, get understanding, because then we'll have more robust universities, we'll have better opportunities for students, and I believe that will create a more robust UK.
In terms of digital learning, teaching and assessment, what do universities and colleges need to know?
There are so many tools that universities could capitalise on by understanding the internet better. You know, there are different ways of working with students, there are different mechanisms to gauge what students are picking up, for testing, for comparing data. It's just a huge world out there to be able to take part in and improve both the student experience and the overall university experience. So I'm not an expert in every single different type of tool or every different single thing that happens on the internet. All I can say is get out there, search around, use it, because from every angle, things are being changed and improved using technology, and doesn't mean that you don't have to have a high quality academic experience or teaching experience, but it can be one of the important tools and planks to make that more a reality.
Have you got any messages for women in the sector who are underrepresented?
You know, the issue of gender balance in practically every dimension is still one that's extremely vexing. You know, I've worked in technology my whole working life. I say this a lot, but the internet did not exist 30 years ago, and yet we have managed to completely replicate the hierarchies and the power structures of industries that have been existing for the last 400 years, and that's very disappointing. And it's true in higher education as well. One of my first questions as OU Chancellor was, how many other female Chancellors or Vice-Chancellors there are? Not enough. So all I can say is, if you're thinking about applying for a promotion, go for it. If you're thinking about coming into the sector, go for it. Don't hold back. We need more women. Women are very well equipped to do any job they want, and we should never try and put the barriers up.
How would separation from Europe impact on our digital future?
I'm a fervent pro-EU campaigner and advocate. I think that it would be disastrous. You know, the whole of the internet and the World Wide Web is about connecting people and not breaking apart into small and fragmented units, but actually working in this incredible collective ambition to create networks of both information, commerce and so on. So, you know, I think the work that the EU has done on the digital single market, on everything from telecoms tariffs through to how we might have micropayments across Europe. These are really important fundamental issues for the strength of all of the economies that Europe has and for our economy. So I think it would be a disaster. And I think also, if you look at what internet entrepreneurs are telling the UK, you know, I saw some numbers recently that said something like 71% of people who are starting internet businesses want to stay in the EU. We should listen to these people. They're the future of the economy. So I would be really extremely upset if we left the EU. And I think it would be very short-sighted from a technological point of view.
Finally, what is the next stage in building Britain's digital future?
I think that there are, for me, probably two big planks, and that's partly what everyone is going to help champion. The first is a universality of usage and understanding. It still feels like we've got a bit of a digital divide. We've got a top tier, got a metropolitan elite very often, got lots of kind of cool commercial startups, but the real mainlining of our understanding of the internet, its use, I think still has some way to go. So that's the first thing. And then I think the second thing is, if I look at what the UK is great at around the world, you know, when we were inventing the NHS or inventing the BBC or inventing the Open University, we've always been at the forefront of how we approach health, how we approach education, what that contract, that social contract is between citizens and between public and private organisations. And again, there's so much that the internet can do to unlock more and better services for us as citizens or us as consumers, and that I think is where the UK could lead. So education and health are a huge part of where I believe we can add value on a global stage.
Thank you very much for talking to you, Saizan.
My pleasure.